Day 66, 3rd of August. We woke in St. Carol's Harbour to a soft rain and the gentle distant foghorn from St. Anthony's. The rain stopped, and the fog it was holding back from the land quickly enveloped us again.
Just catching this as the fog is rolling in this morning, but we lose it. And a mosquito chewing on my finger while I'm doing this. Ouch. That is where we spent the night. Lovely.
As I watch, I wonder if this is what it would be like to be in Scotland. The wild coastline, the cold and the fog. After breakfast, I go to the top of the hill for a look, and I see the fishermen come back after being out for only 35 minutes. I make my way down the wharf for a chat. They had caught 10 large fish, their daily quota, in that short time. Jim, the fisherman, shows me the much-enjoyed local delicacy, the cod tongue. Ew, why would you eat tongue when you have perfectly good fillets? Long story short, I walk away with a bag of fresh cod fillets. But wait, there's more. Jim goes home and gets a bag of frozen moose steaks and brings them back for us. I did have to promise to send him a Christmas card in exchange, or he will send us a storm for Christmas. He was such a sweetheart. I love Newfoundland. Then back to St. Anthony, which is a part of Iceberg Alley. A local told us that a couple of years ago there was an iceberg 11 kilometres long just off the coast, and the small bergs, what they call bergy bits, were being washed up in the harbour. He was also telling us about the polar bear problem they have most spring thaws. They follow the seals down with the icebergs and have to be caught and relocated, usually only one every year or two.
And this shot's taken from on the top of Lighthouse Hill. We've stopped up the top here to have lunch. And the fog is fast moving in here. From the lookout point at the lighthouse at St. Anthony's, just blows in off the sea.
There is a Viking fest and a show in an original style Viking longhouse up by the lighthouse. What a fun day we had today. How about a message in a bottle dropped in the sea at St. Anthony's and washed up 544 days later on a French shore? That was interesting. We learned about Dr. Grenfell, who was a missionary doctor to Newfoundland, and some of his exploits. We learned so much about Newfie things today, like mummers, a Christmas tradition, ugly stick, a musical instrument. Then we mooched our way back down south, down to St. Barbe, ready to catch the ferry to Quebec in the morning. Just because we can. A funny thing we noticed on the way was the St. Anthony Airport is 50 kilometres west of St. Anthony. So there went our day, and fresh cod for dinner, white flaky flesh and so delicate both in texture and flavour. Thank you so much, Jim.